Well, there are fresh warnings this morning to businesses which target low-income Aussies who are using lay-by services to buy goods. It's led by the financial regulator ASIC, who say the most vulnerable in society are prime targets. To discuss further, we're joined by Sarah Court from ASIC. Sarah, thank you for your time this morning. First of all, take us through these businesses. Explain for us who the culprits are.
So, look, these businesses are called Rent4Keeps and Layaway. And what we're concerned about is what you might call a rent-to-own business model, whereby a consumer takes the products that they're after, might be a fridge or a microwave, they take it home with them and then they pay it off over, you know, a year, 2 years, 3 years. And what we're concerned about in these cases we've taken to court today is that these business models, we say, are really deliberately designed to avoid really important consumer protection provisions.
So how are low-income earners targeted exactly? What can we look out for?
So what you need to look out for are the firms which sort of say, look, don't worry if you haven't got a credit history, don't worry if you're on Centrelink payments, you know, we're the business for you. And then, as I say, the customer takes these products and pays what we say are really exorbitant fees. And perhaps if I can just give you an example, one of the consumers that we're concerned about in the Rent4Keeps proceeding is someone that paid about $2,500 from their Centrelink benefits for a fridge that retailed for $365. So obviously really significant fees, and as we say, our concerns here are that these business models are designed to get around consumer protection provisions that would cap the amount that these low-income consumers would have to pay.
Okay, really quickly, a message then for the general public.
So when you're looking at these things, ask the question, how much am I really going to have to pay over time for a fridge? If it cost me $365, ask them, how much is it going to cost? If they told you it was going to cost nearly $2,500, you might go somewhere else.
Good on you, Sarah. Thanks for being with us. A timely warning. Appreciate it. Ali.